Well, today we're in Psalm chapter 87, and it's likely that the writer is in exile or in some way separated from Jerusalem, and he's longing to be there. He begins in verse number one, his foundations, that is God's, is in the holy mountains. The Lord loveth the gates of Zion, that is Jerusalem, more than any dwellings of Jacob. Glorious things are spoken of thee, O city of God. And then he has a pause there, Selah, to consider and meditate on that. But there's a shift in verse 4 through 6 that I want you to see today. He says, "For I will make mention of Rahab and Babylon and them that know me. Behold, Philistine," that is Philistine, "Tyre and Ethiopia. This man was born there." Now, I think what's interesting as you look at this verse is those who were outsiders and sometimes enemies of Israel would be born there and become citizens of Jerusalem. Of course, the writer is not thinking of the physical Jerusalem or the city of Jerusalem in ancient times, but he's thinking of the Jerusalem that is above. Note for just a moment today, and we'll have to really think about what Paul is saying here, but in Galatians chapter 4 and verse 21, what Paul has been doing is contrasting the law, that is the law of Moses, with the gospel, and he's writing to those who oppose the gospel and asking if they really understand what the law said, which obviously they didn't. So in Galatians chapter 4, in verse number 21, Paul said, "Tell me you desire to be under the law." And if they really understood what the law said, they wouldn't desire to be under the law. "Do you hear the law?" So he's asking, do you really understand what the law said? "For it is written that Abraham had two sons, the one by the handmaid and the other by the free woman, Ishmael and Isaac. But he who was of the bondwoman," that is, the bondwoman back in the book of Genesis, of course, and we're looking at chapter 16, was the slave whose name was Hagar, and she was born after the flesh, that is the ordinary birth, and that's important to think about, especially back in Psalm 87. There's going to be contrast to an ordinary birth, that is, it just comes along naturally, and a spiritual birth, using the idea of being born again. But at any rate, that but he who was born after the bondwoman was born after the flesh, but of the free woman was of the promise. Remember that Isaac was the child of promise. And what you're going to see as Paul talks through this passage is the one who was born of Isaac, the child of the promise, would receive the blessings. And he's going to say, well, let's just go ahead and read this, which things are an allegory. So these two women that Paul was talking about is an allegory referring to the two covenants, that is the first covenant and the second covenant. The first covenant, of course, was the covenant that God had made with Israel and given the law. Now notice, and of course the second covenant would be those under the gospel, the one who was at Mount Sinai, that's of course where the law was given. I know you have to stay with me with this for just a moment, but which gendereth the bondage. So those that are born under the law were born into bondage or slavery, which is of Hagar, verse number 24. For this Hagar is Mount Sinai, of course in Arabia, that's where Mount Sinai would be, and answers to Jerusalem, which now is and is in bondage with her children. So really what he's saying here is those under the law are still under bondage, and he's just using the allegory of Ishmael and Hagar. But the Jerusalem which is above, and this is very important, because the Jerusalem which is above is going to have the inclusion of those who are faithful to God, who come under the umbrella of the gospel, those who are redeemed. So the Jerusalem of above is not the Jerusalem of old or the ancient city of Jerusalem, but the Jerusalem of above actually is referring to the church, that is those who are in the church, which is the mother of all. For it is written, "Rejoice, thou barren that bearest not, break forth and cry." And he goes on to say, "For they are desolate, and she has no husband." Now notice here, verse 28, "Now we, brethren, has Isaac," and again notice that not Ishmael, but Isaac, are the children of promise. That's the whole point of this particular passage. He's contrasting those who are under the law and those who are under the gospel, those who are in bondage and those who are free, not of the old Jerusalem, those who are under of the old Jerusalem or the unbelieving Jews. So when he gets down to verse number 30, and I know that this may be difficult to do in sort of a short talk today, that knows, nevertheless, what saith the scripture, cast out the bondwoman and her son, for she is of the bondwoman, and they shall not be heir with the son of the free woman. The free woman, of course, Sarah and the Jerusalem of above. And what he's really doing is contrasting those who are saved and those who are lost, those who are free, and those who are in bondage. But the point of all of this, back in Psalm 87, is those that were outside the covenant, who were without God and without hope, are now, you see, have hope and are redeemed. So this is simple, the point here, this Jerusalem, which ought to be, you know, the one that we desire and one that we want to be part of and one that we want to be born into, being born again spiritually, ought to be the Jerusalem above and not the old Jerusalem, because the old Jerusalem, or the physical city of Jerusalem, carries no weight anymore. And what ought to be driving us and be our desire is to be part of that Jerusalem above, that heavenly citizenship, that freedom, that salvation that is in the Christian church. And that's his whole point there. And that's what the psalmist is referring to, that day would come and has come. But you can be part of that when you become a Christian and be part of that Jerusalem which is above. So I hope those are some thoughts. We'll have to think through that a little bit more deeply sometime, but I hope that that's helpful as far as giving you further study as we go through the book of Psalms.